Hi there, my name's Tony Grigorjevs, reporter from the Angling Times, and today I've come up north to North Yorkshire to Brompton Lakes. And this is a fantastic two-lake complex and it's a holiday resort as well. 20 fantastic lodges throughout, but the fishing is absolutely fantastic. Now, what we've got here is an autumn, typical autumn's day. It's bright, it's not very warm, we've had a frost overnight. As you can see in the background, there's no ripple on the water and it's really tough conditions. But the main thing is, if you get your tactics right, you can catch fish. And over the next few weeks, I'm going to show you a few tactics that can help you put a few more fish in your net during this cold spell and throughout winter as well. Now, the first tactic I'm going to talk about today is fishing on the straight lead, but not as conventionally do it with maggots and corn on the bottom, but with pop-ups. Now, a lot of people have the misconception that fish live on the bottom during the winter, but actually, they could be living at any depth. They could be living 2 foot under, half depth, 3/4, or even on the deck, and it's a matter of working it out. And with pop-ups, you get to cover all depths. So, basically, first of all, I'm going to talk you through the tackle we use. First thing, we've got a 12-foot rod with a very soft action tip, because the idea of having a soft action tip is in winter, that the bites are not going to be ferocious takes. They very rarely are, to be honest with you, when you're fishing on the straight lead with pop-ups. Usually, it just arcs round very gently. Either that, or sometimes you get little dropbacks. So we need a very soft tip on the rod. In terms of the main line, again, it really does depend on what size of fish you're fishing for. Here at Brompton, we've got fish sort of between 2 to 4 pound, with the odd bigger fish. So 4 pound Maxima does the job here. But again, step it up to possibly 6 pound if you're fishing for fish up to double figures. Hook link, gone for all 16 today. Again, you want to get the fish in, but you want to fish as light as possible. Could drop down to all 14 maybe. Again, if it's bigger fish, you might want to stop up to all 18. In terms of the lead, just got a 1/2 ounce bomb there, but again, depends how far you're casting, so alternate with it. You really want to use the lightest bomb you can. Today, I'm casting into the open water behind me, but what I've got on there is a little swivel with a snap link. Now, if I wanted to chuck to the island, which you can see behind me, a 1/2 ounce probably isn't going to be quite enough. So I've got the snap link. What I can do is I can just unclip that from there, run the bomb off, and then I'll just take another bomb, like so, like I would. That's the same bomb, just for example. Clip it back on, and you're away fishing again. And you don't have to break your tackle down, which is a very quick and effective way. Also, the same with your hook links with pop-ups. Now the idea is, I'll just undo that from there, unclip that from a reel. And what you effectively want to do is you want to scour as much water as possible. Now, you'll be able to see in my hand there, that's a 10mm Nash Baits pop-up, that is. Lots of companies do them. Ringers Baits, Dynamite Baits, Mainline. I've gone for the Nash ones just because of the variety of colours we've got. Now, you see in my hand there, we've got yellows, we've got oranges, we've got pinks. And the idea is to put something bright into the clear water just for the fish to see. So, how does it work once it's in the water? Effectively, what you'll have is your straight lead. Your straight lead will sit on the bottom, like so. That'll be your straight lead, that'll sit on the bottom, and that will pop up there off the bottom. It'll just sit there wafting around. Now, the fish might not be 12 inches off the bottom, they could be a little bit further up, but then what you do is you've got a quick change bead there, you can take your hook link off, and you can go to an 18 inch hook link. That doesn't work, try a 2 foot hook link, and keep changing the depths up and down. Another great thing with this is you don't need to be massively accurate with casting. Work your way around your swim. All you're trying to do is find pockets of fish, because in winter the fish will ball up. If you can chuck out, don't get any indications within a few minutes, reel in, re-chuck, start getting a few liners, maybe drop short, and it's just working around. And it's a busy way of fishing, rather than just sitting, looking at the tip, waiting for the tip to go around. It's a busy way of fishing, just constantly casting around. Now, it can take you a while to find the fish, but I say it's all about keeping active. Change the colour of your pop-up regularly, change the length of your hook link, cast into new spots, but eventually you will find the fish. Now today we've gone with the 10mm version, but what you can, and the simple way to hook that is what's called a bayonet. Now that's basically the shank of a hook. The point of the hook's been cut off, and we've just got that. So what you do is you just impale the boilie, like so. That goes through there, and that pops off the end of your hair, like so. And in winter, it really is unbeatable. Now, you really should give that a go. So, but the other thing is, there's plenty of other pop-up baits to try. Rather than out here in the cold, let's get inside and have a look at what other baits we can use. Right then, we're back inside. We've had an enjoyable morning sport, but as you know, in winter or autumn, so it does get a little bit chilly. So, thought I'd come back inside and, as we said earlier, show you a few more pop-ups. We've been looking at pop-up boilies this morning, which do work fantastic, but there are a number of varieties. Some places don't allow boilies, so you need to look for alternatives. And I've picked three of the best alternatives for you to give a try this year. The first one I found
are expander pellets in reasonably big sizes. Now obviously these are usually used on the pole and they're usually pumped so they're dampened and sink, but we're not going to use them like that. The best way to use these as a pop-up is basically just to put them in a band untreated and they pop straight off the bottom, and what you'll find is they expand slowly as they would when you've pumped them and bits drop off. So every say 10 minutes give them a change. Try various sizes. These are 11mm, but you'd be surprised what a carp can fit into the mouth. So 11mm, 8mm, even 6mm if it's really tough. But keep varying it. So put it in the band, let it sit off the hook, they work really well. The second one is an old favourite, bread. Bread discs are absolutely fantastic, and to be honest with you, the amount of big catches that have been caught at venues across the country in recent weeks and in recent years has been incredible. All you need to do is punch a couple of discs out with a punch, like so, literally just punch it out, take your punch from in there, then you run that onto a hair rig and then hair rig bread. You can do two discs, three discs, one disc, whatever works. What's important with hair rig bread is to have it sat off the hook, so have quite a long hair, because what happens with bread is it expands quite quickly, so you don't want it covering the point of your hook. So it's a good advice to use anything between sort of half an inch and an inch of a hair rig. Again, run it over, put a baiting needle in, run it over the band, and then it stays on perfectly. The third one, which you've got sat in the middle here, you may be wondering what that is, and to be honest with you, it's something that's rarely used and is pretty unusual. It's marshmallows, basically the kids' sweets that you can buy. These are brilliant alternative venues that have been fished heavily. And the great thing about these is they seep off a lot of flavouring. A lot of the aroma comes off and a lot of dusting comes off, as you'll probably be able to see just looking at that. And again, tear off a piece, just take out a normal flump like that, tear off a piece and hair rig it on again. And those three baits, along with the pop-up boilies, should do everything for you this winter. If you need pop-up baits, look at these four, you'll catch plenty of fish. So thanks for watching, my name is Tony Grigorjevs and we'll see you again soon.